Let's look at our instruction scheduling quiz solution. As is, this takes one cycle to do the load. If the load latency was one cycle, then the add could happen the next cycle. But because the load takes two cycles, the add can only happen in cycle three. So we have one cycle three. The add takes only one cycle, so the store can proceed. Then we can do the load. It doesn't depend on anything, so we can do the load in cycle five. The add, however, can now happen only in cycle 7, and finally the store happens in cycle 8, so as is, this executes in 8 cycles. The question is now, can we schedule this better to avoid some of these stalls? And we had a stall here and here. To avoid a stall here, we need to place between the load and the add an instruction that can be done here without violating dependencies. We can see that this load here doesn't depend on any of the previous three instructions, except that we will destroy R1 if we move that instruction here. So the correct solution to this is we will move the load there, but we will rename our R1 into something else. So the program becomes now load word R1, 0 of R2 as before. Now we move the other load there, put the result in some R10, let's say. Now we can do this add because in the third cycle, we can do it. Now that we have done this add, we can actually do this add. The load has already happened. We are now in the second cycle since then, so the second add can happen. The add was using R1, now we have to use R10. Next, we will do our store and the last remaining store. As you can see, now we have a processor where whenever we need two cycles for the load, there is something in between the load and the use of its result. Here, R1 is loaded, we then don't use R1, and then we add to it. And here, R10 is loaded, and then we don't do anything with R10, and then we add to it. So this can be done in 6 cycles, eliminating both of the stall cycles that we previously had.